Please subscribe to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button, and don't forget to click on the bell icon to get further notifications.
Scaling web applications. First, what is the meaning of scaling? Suppose we have an application running on a web server. Obviously, every web server has certain limitation. The limitation will be in terms of the compute resources which are available to that particular web server. In other words, the amount of RAM available, the amount of processing speed available, the networking speed available, all this, the storage which is available, all these things are limited. Maybe they are pretty high in number or volume which is available, but still there is a limit. So when there is a request coming, and if it has to be effectively executed on server, it would need these resources. And the application should be capable enough to handle hundreds of requests, and it should be able to scale. Now the word scale, even if the number of requests are increasing drastically. So how does the cloud platform, how does Azure web apps provide scalability? In other words, how does the applications ensure that they do not crash even with the increased amount of load? That is what we will have to see now. Now for this, there are always, remember, two types of scalability requirements. One is the vertical scaling and the other is the horizontal scaling. Now what is vertical and what is horizontal? Now when we say vertical scaling, we call that as scale up or scale down. Scale up, scale down. That's what we call it as vertical scaling. See, many requests are going to execute slow for the reason that on a system we have got limited RAM and CPU, but the number of objects which are created in memory is pretty high. But the amount of processing speed required for execution is not sufficient. That is the reason the applications become slow. That is a normal routine requirement. The only choice we have in such kind of cases is increase the amount of RAM and increase the amount of CPU. CPU cores at least. Because we are working with a virtual machine. The number of CPU cores can be increased. The RAM can be increased. And like that, the applications can become scalable to handle the load from multiple clients, multiple users. Another important scaling is horizontal scaling, which we call it as scale in, scale out. Now, what is the reason that scaling and scale out kind of requirement would come up? The bottleneck here is in terms of the network communication or maybe the disk access. See, many times an application has to communicate with an external service. That means something which is running on another machine, not on the same machine. It can be a web service. It can be a database server. It can be a storage account. It can be anything else as well. So when it has to execute the request, and at the time of executing the request, if the code requires us to have access to the external resource, what is happening to the request when the trip is being made? Yes, the request is on hold. Because the request is on hold, the response is not rendered to the client. And because of the same reason, we will not have many parallel clients executing at the same time. Mind you, on a web server, for every request, we will have a new thread created, multi-threading thread. And that thread will get into the pause state, or at least the block state, while it is sending a request to the external resource and waiting for the response. And very important, the number of threads which can be created on every web server is a limited number. It's not unlimited. So when one request is waiting for the response, it is not using any CPU or RAM. And at the same time, another request cannot make use of it because that is blocked. Because the current thread is in block state, it will not let other requests also to execute. This kind of problem can be solved only by increasing the number of virtual machines. We will have our application deployed on multiple virtual machines so that the load can get divided between them. few requests will go on some web server and few other requests will go on a different web server. So side by side execution of requests will happen, and even if there is a waiting period for a thread, it would not affect other requests. It would not affect other clients, and everybody will get the response without timeout error. So very precisely, how are we going to have this vertical and horizontal scaling implemented for our application? That's what we will have to see now. So we have the application here. We have to go to the settings, scale up, scale out. Basically scale up, scale down, scale out, scale in. So this is vertical scaling and this will be for horizontal scaling. But remember, whether it is vertical or horizontal, we are actually not scaling the web application. We are actually scaling the application service plan, because it is the service plan which decides the amount of resources which are allocated to our application. The RAM, the processing speed, number of cores, all these are on the basis of service plan. See, we are always scaling a service plan. We are not scaling a web application. Very important point. So I go to first scale up, and we can see different pricing tier there, and we can always scale from one pricing tier to the other pricing tier. So let's say if I was in basic, I may change from one core to two core and 1.75 GB RAM to 3.5 GB RAM. Like that, this is scaling up. This is scaling up. So from one level, lower RAM to higher RAM. But remember, scaling up does not mean going from basic to standard, because basic also has got one core, 1.75 GB RAM. Here also it is one core and 1.75 GB RAM. That's not scaling. Very important. So right now it is standard. I'll keep it as standard only, because certain features are not supported in basic. Like auto scaling feature is not there. You can see here, we have got up to 10 instances, which is required for horizontal scaling. And also there is a support for auto scaling. Whereas here we have got only up to 3 instances, and that is also manual scaling. So I'm keeping the setting as standard and OK. So vertical scaling is very clear. Remember, when we are changing the pricing tier, going from one level to the other level, or even if you are increasing the RAM and CPU cores, the web server is not going to be stopped. It is not going to be stopped and restarted. All the requests will continue to get served even when there is a scaling happening in background. That's very, very important. We don't have any downtime for the web application. So vertical scaling is pretty simple. But how to do this horizontal scaling? Yeah, there are two types in this. One is manual and the other is automatic. If it is manual, based on the load, you can decide and increase the instance count. Right now I can go up to 10 because I've used the standard SKU. If I would have used the basic, it would have been only 3. Right now I can go up to 10. Now, very important. When I say 10 instances, remember, our cost is getting multiplied by 10. Whatever is the cost provided here is for per instance. So if you go for increased number of instances, the cost also is going to increase. Very, very important. So let's say I keep it as 2 and I test my application. Now, when we are testing the application, what we will realize is certain graphs will be generated. Performance graphs will be generated, and we can look at them here. I mean, hardly there is anything here. Data in, data out, the request lifetime, the average response time. It's hard, very less right now. If that is increasing, then we will have to consider increasing number of instances or increasing the RAM. So I go back here. And this time I would like to show you how to do automatic scaling. Now you have to give some name, let's say weekends. Now let's assume that weekends our load is less and on weekdays the load is more. Let's assume that. And we want this to be a varying factor on weekends and weekdays. So for weekends, I would like to do scaling now. Scale mode, it can be either based on metrics or it can be based on the instance count. Now for this, we will have to add rules. I'll keep it based on a metric. What is the rule? The rule is simple. If the CPU usage, which is average, greater than, let's say, 80 for continuously 5 minutes. The CPU usage is greater than 80 for continuously 5 minutes. I would like to increase my instance count by 1. But in next 5 minutes, nothing should happen. After increasing the instance count, next 5 minutes, even if the duration continues to remain, if the average continues to remain more than 80, don't do anything. That's what is cooldown period. Click on add. So right now I have done based on a metric. Click on add scale condition and specify the schedule also. Repeat specific days, you can say. Repeat specific days and now click on add rule and choose the days. No. Sorry, here only they have given now. And we can choose the days. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. This is weekends. So it should be the other way. Sunday and Saturday. And you may decide to keep it as fixed instances 1. On Sunday and Saturday, I don't want any kind of scaling based on the metric. I just keep it as 1. And you can add more rules, which can probably be for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. How many number of instances are there minimum? How many maximum can be there? Let's say 5. And the default is maybe 2. You can control actually. And you can add a rule. And the rules can be based on the CPU, data in, data out, HTTP queue length, how many requests are coming, disk queue length, memory percentage, amount of memory. All this can be the different metrics. So you'll have to keep changing this and see how is your application performing. That's the job of somebody managing the web application. The graphs have to be monitored. You have to check, are there any requests which are scaling out? Or is your application crashing because of lack of memory? And these kind of things all you'll have to take into consideration at the time of configuring scaling. Of course, I'm discarding it because I cannot demonstrate this. You have to just take it for granted. It's working in background. That's it. You can see run history in last 1 day, last 12 hours. There's nothing right now because there are no requests. Otherwise, graph will be there. Proper graph will be there. Auto scaling, how did it happen? That also you can see here. So beautiful feature which makes our application to sustain increased amount of load when needed, and at the same time we can always decrease the amount of load. For example, I did not show you this, let me go back. I can always say add a rule, average CPU is less than, let's say 20%. I can say decrease count by 1. I can do that also. I can increase and I can decrease. Both the things can be done. And all these are configured and kept so that automatically the application is going to increase the instance count or decrease the instance count. We do not have to do it manually. In case we want to do it manually, yes, we always have the choice. Just choose the option manual. And manual can be again configured on the basis of days. Just scale to a specific instance, keep it as 3. That is default. Scale to a specific instance, let's say 2 on, or maybe 1 on weekends. Like that you can do it. This is default, you cannot change the condition here, but otherwise you are able to. Let's say on Monday, Tuesday, I'll have only one instance. So on and on. Now, very important, whenever you are doing scale down, the current request will complete execution on that server. Subsequent request will not be diverted to that server. That means whether you are doing scale up or scale down, in either case, your application will not get any, your application will not have any downtime in either case. That will be automatically taken care by Azure without our knowledge. You can see disable auto scaling. Once enabled, goes back to manual scaling, and so on. So beautiful feature. Lot of certification questions will be asked from this, and the answers are pretty simple, which I've already given to you. All this is notes which you may want to read later. The UI has changed now. It's no more the way it is given in the handout. It's changing every now and then actually. Now, let us